This is the Bobcat News.
With your anchors, Kennedy Brown and Larissa Myers.
Where every Bobcat matters every day.
Privet Bobcats, that's high in Russian.
Welcome Bobcats, it's your new favorite anchors, Kennedy and Larissa. Today is National Picnic Day. As you can see, we were in the middle of an indoor one. Here's this week's trivia. Who invented the word picnic? A. France, B. America, C. China, or D. Jamaica?
With all the Y-top testing going on, we are reading a lot. Are you needing something new to read? We have a few book recommendations for you.
I'm Maya from Mr. Bauer's class, and I have a book recommendation for Land of Stories Beyond the Kingdoms. It's a really interesting book, and it has a lot of plot twists. It's where Alex and Connor Bailey go into a fairy tale world and have to defeat a villain, and they have to recruit an army also. So.
My name is Rohan Sundaresan, and I'm from Mrs. Steiger's class. And the book I'm recommending is Septimus Heap, the first book, Magic. It's about, it's this story, and it goes on a lot of twists and turns, and at first you don't know who Septimus is, and then you learn about Septimus, but then the end gives you a totally different thing, and it just really goes from one idea, and then it's changed a few chapters later.
Hello, my name is Emma Sims, and I'm from Miss Writer's class, and my favorite book would be Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, because it is magical, mysterious, and I just really like it when he finds out that who his godfather is, and yeah, that's just a really good book, and I recommend it. Thank you. Bye.
Okay, so my name's Cole, and I am from Miss Barry's class, and the book I recommend is The Long Winter, because, I don't know, it's about a family who travels west, and it's a pretty good book.
I'm Cassidy Schaefer from Miss Linton's class, and my book recommendation is Fairest. It's about this girl named Aza, and she has a magical power where she could sing off of anything, and she attends the castle, and she becomes the lady-in-waiting.
I'm Emery Michael from Ms. Durham's class, and I recommend I Survive books. They're really good, and they're about tornadoes and State Helens books, and I recommend them, so yeah.
A book I recommend is called Bomb the Race to Build and Destroy the World's Most Dangerous Weapon. It's a complete history of the arms race in the 1950s through the 1990s.
Hi, I'm Scarlett Frood, and I would like to request a book. It's A Grenade from Alan Gratz, and it tells about how in World War II, and about these two people, one's named Ray, and the other's name is, I forgot. But they both meet at one point, and the Japanese guy kills Ray on accident. And then it haunts him.
My name is Sophie, and I'm from a Stevens class. And the book I'm doing is called A Christmas After All. It's from A Dear America, and it's about this girl named Millie, and it's during the Great Depression, and all about how her family lives through part of the Great Depression during Christmas.
I'm Gavin from Mrs. Robertson's class, and I'm recommending Treasure Hunters because there's a lot of adventure, and they lose their parents in a storm, and they're trying to find them.
Hi, my name is Eden Kemp from Miss Park class, and the book that I would recommend is Strawberry Girl. I liked it because it was about this girl who moved into a new house, and she met some friends, and it's really good.
We will be starting a new fun challenge here at Baldwin Creek called Book Rock. Alea, Catherine, and James will explain more.
Hello, Bobcats. It's me, Alea, and I'm here, and I'm going to explain what the book rocks are. So the book rocks are little rocks that we have made, and they will have a character's name or a quote from a book. Miss Jordan did a quote, and I've done a name. And we will hide them around the school, and if you know what book it is from, you will go to the library, and if you know what it is, you will win a prize.
James and I are here to look for some book rocks, so let's see if we can find some.
So, we found a couple rocks with either book characters, and if you find one of these, and you'll receive a prize.
If you know what book they are from.
Starting Monday, and if you bring back the rock twice and you get it correct, you will not get a prize for that.
If you would like to come in and do a rock, you need to schedule a time with Miss Jordan. Have an amazing day, Bobcats. Bye!
I wonder what the weather will be like next week. Aria?
Hi, Bobcats. I'm your new BCE meteorologist. This week, I will be using my trusty weather wand. On Monday, it will be mostly sunny with a high of 55 degrees and a low of 34 degrees. There is a 24% chance of precipitation. On Tuesday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 52 degrees and a low of 33 degrees. There is a 24% chance of precipitation. For Wednesday, the weather will be mostly sunny with a high of 59 degrees and a low of 38 degrees with a 4% chance of precipitation. On Thursday, there will be a high of 63 degrees and a low of 41 degrees, with a 5% chance of precipitation. The weather will be partly cloudy. Finally, for Friday, it will be partly cloudy. There will be a high of 61 degrees and a low of 39 degrees, with a 24% chance of precipitation. Even though the weather, sadly, will be warm, you still need to dress appropriately for the weather. That means when it is cold, wear warm clothing, and when it's not, don't wear the same clothing. Bye, Bobcats!
Let's see what our athletes are accomplishing this week. Take it away, Veda!
Hello, fantastic Bobcats. It's me, Veda Havens, but this time I'm doing sports. Here's a sport joke. Why didn't the dog want to play football? We have some amazing Bobcats at wrestle. Here are some of the results from state wrestling. Harley Velarde placed first and second. Taylor Freeman placed second, and Arya Gormley placed third. Ryan Harder, Brian Gormley, Arya Wallingbull, and Tanner Goliath also competed. Great job, Bobcats. We also have a lot of Bobcats that do Strikers soccer. They have tournaments this weekend in Riverton. Some of the Parks and Rec team games have been canceled because of the snow, but they should have games next week. There's no baseball this weekend, but they are still practicing on the field. Swimmers have been working really hard on their technique. Dancers are practicing for their recitals on May 15th. And if you want to do a sport but don't know what to do, here are some ideas you can try out. Kickball, pickleball, soccer, baseball, and dance. If you have any other ideas, come tell Miss Jordan or me, and I will mention them in the next broadcast. It's sunny out there, so get a parent, guardian, friend, or sibling, and get to playing some sports. The answer to that joke is, it was a boxer. Veda Havens, signing off.
As a follow-up for Earth Day, which was yesterday, Sarah will interview someone from Textile Exchange.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm here with Ashley from Textile Exchange to see how their company helps the environment. What does Textile Exchange do?
Textile Exchange helps companies that make clothes find the best materials that they can. So our clothes are made from all different kinds of materials like cotton or polyester or even rayon, nylon, all kinds of different materials. It comes from sheep, from plants, from oil that comes out of the ground. And Textile Exchange helps companies use the best materials that don't hurt the environment.
How does Textile Exchange help the environment?
So whenever a company comes to us, they a lot of times will say, we don't know where our materials come from, and we also don't know if they're maybe doing bad things that we don't know about. So Textile Exchange can give them more information about where some of that material comes from and how they can improve that material and make their clothes better in the future. So one example of that is, have you ever seen maybe on your food or something, you'll see a product that says that it's made from organic ingredients? Have you seen that before? So you can also grow cotton organically. So I grew up on a cotton farm in West Texas. And whenever I was your age, one of my jobs in the summer was to spray chemicals onto the weeds to kill them. But that's not really very good for the environment because that chemical just goes into the ground and then it's kind of there forever. So organic agriculture is grown without using pesticides or without using chemicals like that. So we help companies use materials that don't use chemicals and are nice to animals and don't mess up water, things like that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye.
Do you want to be featured on the Bobcat News? If you do outstanding work and specials, and you might just have the chance to be a featured student. Let's see what this week's featured students are.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm here with Nora Wright, the fourth grade featured student of the week. Nora, what is your favorite subject?
Independent reading.
All right. What kind of books do you like to read?
I like reading kind of scary books, fantasy, that kind of stuff.
Nice. Do you do any after-school activities like sports or music?
I do wrestling.
Cool. What are some of your hobbies and interests?
I like riding my bike and playing with my siblings.
All right. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I don't really know yet.
All right, cool.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm here with Braden Allen, the fifth grade feature student of the week. Braden, what's your favorite subject?
My favorite subject is science.
What kind of books do you like to read?
The Last Kids on Earth and Dare of a Wimpy Kid series.
Do you do any after-school activities like sports or music?
I do soccer.
What are some of your hobbies and interests?
I like video games and reading.
And what do you want to be when you grow up?
I'm a scientist.
Thanks.
Here are this week's reminders. Fourth grade will participate in Outdoor Ed Day on Friday, April 30th. Students should bring a hat, sunscreen, dress in layers, and bring a sack lunch. Be ready for a fun day.
With rain and snow, there is usually a lot of mud on the playground this time of year. Please do your best to avoid the mud. If you do get mud on your shoes, try to wipe it off before you come into the school.
Our final week of the summative YTOP testing is next week. It is very important to get lots of rest and eat healthy. We know everyone has worked hard this school year, and this is our chance to show what we have learned.
Keep reading to reach those AR goals and keep walking or running to earn those blazing Bobcat miles. The answer of that trivia question was B. Just kidding. As much as we consider your picnic spot to be an American tradition, the answer is A, France. Bye, Bobcats. We hope you enjoyed your new favorite anchors. Now let's get back to that picnic.
Yeah, au revoir, Bobcats. That's bye in French. See you next time on the Bobcat News.
Was a bug, little bug, hardly there.